Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player.
Good morning. Ira Epstein of Linn Associates with your morning flash update for this Wednesday, the 21st of February, 2018, about 9:20 a.m. Central Standard Time. All right, we're still getting this volatility in the stock market, a reasonable amount of it. As you can see, the Dow itself, about 200-point range. You're sitting here with about 60-point range in the NASDAQ. The gold market fairly stable today. The range in the market about $9, up $2 on the day. Silver coming back, gaining a little bit on this. Copper market flat, while the platinum market just sort of sitting. Now, on the Bitcoin, you're down $1,100. If you're starting to get my reports and you're listening to what I'm talking about, you were approaching a Bollinger Band top on the Bitcoin that you'd be looking at as an area where maybe the market sees some pullback. The good thing that's going for Bitcoin is regulation. And people will say, well, that knocks it out of the game. That's really not what's happening. What's happening is the more the market matures and regulates, well, you get down to the road where people start saying, okay, show me the use for it, not that it's not going to exist. That's still going to be the big problem, as I see it, for all the virtual currencies. What is the use for them? Blockchain's here to stay. You're going to be using that in factoring, in banks. You're going to use it in manufacturing down the road. You're going to already using it in cargo shipments of soybeans. We saw that used already. Dollar up a little bit. There's a lot of economic data we'll talk about as you're pulling back slightly in a number of the currencies. And obviously, the elephant in the room continues to be U.S. interest rates, which, as you know, have gone higher. The Treasury has been putting a lot out on the line to auction. There's more auctions today coming up, in fact. As we take a look at energies, I think the key word here is stable for a bit. The bean market still rallying as the meal market stays under stress in Argentina. And as long as that is the game, that game is very serious. Now, corn and wheat, they sort of broke away from that, being pulled along with it so far. So we'll see where that carries it. Today we had the U.S. National Association of Realtors come out, and we saw a drop in January of 3.2% in home sales. They were looking for it up 1.25%. That's quite a shock to the other way. The amount of home sales, 5.38 million on an annualized rate. They expected 5.64. Price continues to go up. You'll say, why are lower numbers, amount being sold, yet price going up? Short supply is the problem. Then there's another issue that's dealing here. As you know, we're capping the amount on mortgages with the new tax reform plan. How does that all play out in the market? We're learning. So this is another part that you're seeing to that market. As for the market, U.S. preliminary February manufacturing sector PMI, 55.9 versus an expected 55.3. It's a good number. U.S. preliminary February service sector PMI, 55.9 versus 54, again firing on all parts. German manufacturing sector PMI, well, this is where we start getting numbers that are a little off. It was 63, they were looking for 60.6 and well down from the 61.1 that we saw in December. The service sector PMI in the Eurozone was 56.7, down from last month's 58 and below expectation of the economists of 57.6. The manufacturing, 58.5, down from the 59.6. So we're starting to see some softness there. And that will probably keep the, if you will, the doves saying to the hawks, no, 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 it's not time for us to be changing all these policies. Treasury auctions today, you're going to have a $35 billion five-year T-note and then a $15 billion floating rate note today. And at the end of the day, well, I'm talking, I think it's 12 o'clock or so, we're going to get the Federal Reserve minutes from the last meeting of Ms. Yellen. We are expecting those meetings notes to be a bit hawkish. Remember, she was saying the economy was doing better. The Fed after that was talking, do we get three or four rate hikes, not two or three? So things you've got to think about and how the market's going to all play out with it. I want to remind you, let's see if I can get this to come up, and I can't, so I'm not going to worry about it at this point. I had something I wanted to show, and we'll forget that. I will catch you in the second part of the afternoon when we do all the reviews for your videos for the agriculture, financial markets, and, of course, the all-important metals. With that, I'm Ira Epstein. You have yourself a good trading day, and I will talk to you all then.